The multifunction gives us plenty of options on how we can manage our pieces after we template them. Maybe we need to rotate or move them around. We can do that with the multi-tool. Multi works in one of two ways. If we have click each turned off, it allows me to select exactly what I want by clicking and dragging. It then gives me all my options. We also have the ability then to turn on click each, give me the ability to select individual lines. Or I have one more option where I can come in and actually select by color. So if I come in and try to select by color, I can say that I want to move all of my flat polish. By doing that, it then highlights all of my flat polish, and now all my options are allowed for just that color or that line. Now, what we're going to work with first is we're going to just do the dragging of a box. So we're going to come through and say, I want to have this turned off. I'm going to select my piece. Now, erase is pretty simple. Erase allows me to select. Now, this is different than the erase that's on this side. This erase will allow me to click one individual piece, but when I select this piece, if I click on this erase, it erases the whole thing at once. Now, if I come through and highlight the whole thing, the next one is offset. Offset allows me to move my piece in one direction, and that one direction is going to show up with four arrows. When I click on it, whatever I have this set up top here for 3/4, it's going to move it that distance. So if I click to the right, it's going to keep moving it 3/4 of an inch. Now, I have one other option within select the piece and going back to offset. I can have keep original. This is a very good way to copy and paste something if I need a duplicate of the exact same thing multiple times. I'm going to turn on keep original, but I'm going to change this to 30 inches. By having this on here, it's going to copy it and paste a new one 30 inches below. So it's giving me the ability to copy it multiple times. If maybe we have an apartment complex that's using the same vanities, we just need to make copies of them. It's kind of a quick, easy way to do that. Now, when we go back into multi this time, I'm going to select the same piece, but now I'm going to hit the move button. First thing we can do is just click and drag wherever we want to place it. We can tuck that nicely in there. That's option one. Now, if I come back in here and select my piece again and hit move, I can also use snap points. At this point, I have the ability to select some snap point, as you can see all of them, on my piece, and then click on another snap point somewhere else, and it ties the two points together, meaning I now combine those two pieces. So with that, we kind of have some nice, easy options on moving. Now, we're going to get into rotate. When I click on rotate, the easiest thing is I can just click plus 45, and it's just going to keep rotating at 45 degrees every single time. Do have the option also to come in here and type in my angle, or just click on the buttons here, and it will adjust it as well. The next one that we're going to talk about is edge, and I'm going to go ahead and switch to another page. Now, with edge, this one here is specifically a rotational function that tells it I want to rotate this edge to this edge. So it's going to rotate them automatically for me. So I'm going to click on edge, click on the first line, on the piece I highlighted, and click what I want it rotated to. So in this case, I have two seams and I want them rotated together. Now, why they were rotated that way, who knows? But basically, it's a good way to rotate your pieces to line them up if you need to. So maybe you brought a piece from one page to another and you want to rotate them together. Multi edge will help us to get that there. Now, the next one is going to be a grouping function. Group allows me to click on this and group these lines, meaning that is now one solid entity. So if I come in here and try to erase one part of this, it's now going to treat it like a drop-in where it's actually going to see the whole thing as one. So if I click on element, it will erase that and it ungroups it. But some machines, some people will group pieces together so that it's looking at it as a whole entity rather than it being separate pieces. Now, the other option that we have then right after that one is we can select it and ungroup it. Now, where these really come into play is when you're dealing with a sink. Sometimes sinks will come in as grouped, and it's sometimes good to ungroup them to kind of get started. That way, we can edit each individual line without messing with the rest of the product. The next function that we're going to get into is going to be paste. Paste, I covered this in another video, but paste allows me to paste it here so I can copy and paste it to the same page, or it gives me the ability if I turn it to, instead of paste here, I can turn it to select a page. This allows me to then copy and paste it to another page. Then I can drag it before I let it go. If I turn my snaps off, I can just drag and drop. The last thing that we have is reference. Maybe I want something on my drawing, like this piece. If I go into here and turn that into a reference, it actually turns it to reference only, meaning it's not going to be part of the actual output. It's just part of the drawing itself so that we can see it as a reference, but it might be on a separate page for our cut file. So if we need to have something on there maybe for a layout, but it's not maybe there for the same reasons as materials, if the materials are different, we want to show it, but we don't want to cut it in that material, we can put it on as a reference only. Then it will show up on the shop sheets, but it's not going to output.